Good afternoon, everyone. This is 287, and to those who are keeping the Sabbath, I hope you're having a happy and blessed Sabbath. Today, I'm going to do a short video in response to a PM that was sent, and I'm just going to focus on a few areas of it and forego unimportant information like who sent it, because that's not important. The important thing is some of the context and what this individual is going through and what some of us may have already been through or what we may face. And hopefully I can help through my viewpoint in giving some positive and edifying direction in that. So with that being said, here we go. The letter reads, just dropping by to say hi. And the first point that it gets to, it says, I have a prayer request, if you don't mind. For whatever reason or so, for the last month or so, I have been questioning if God is even real and am I wasting my time. So let's focus on that point for just a moment. Well, this person is not the first person to question whether the Heavenly Father is real or not. Well, let's look at it just from some simple aspects. All around us, including ourselves, had to have been created by some superior power. Now, those of us who are believers refer to that power as God by some name or another. And even those who don't believe understand that all was created by some superior intelligence or power. So we know that there's a creator. And we can argue and debate the points about who what, but we know there is a creator. So for those of us who are believers, most people say God. So we're going to say there is a God just based on the notion of creation. Okay, and the next point, the individual says, I'm not suffering, but things just don't seem to be fair. Well, even in the world, we know that life isn't fair, but this gets to be a point with some individuals when they're going through things, because we all want fairness. We don't want to feel like we're being unfairly treated when we can see around us all the things that are happening to those who aren't doing things the right way in the first place. And that's where we can start to get caught up. Now, the letter goes on and says that I see some of the most undeserving, unconcerned people who seem to have it all. And I'm going to stop right there, because there's a little phrase right after that that really answers the entire question in that aspect. Now, we as believers have to keep in mind that we aren't here in this world to be satisfied with this world. This is the problem with us in the first place. Because we want so much of this world, we want to build our treasures and our desires and everything that we want. We want to fulfill in this world. This is what gets us tripped up. The Father, all throughout Scripture, keeps reaffirming to us that we are not to build our treasures up, our desires, the things that are going to benefit us are not of this world. We're to build all that up for the heavenly world. While we're here, we're going to be tested and tempted in every aspect, as was the Savior himself, if not more. No, not more, because he was tested and tempted in all points imaginable to man. So we see that he prevailed, and we can prevail. We can be tested no more than the Father will allow to be put on us. He knows our strengths. He knows our weaknesses. But in all that, he will not let us be overburdened. He will not let us be overburdened. no matter what we're going through, if you recognize you're going through something, you have to remember that you can get through it through Him. Of our own accord, we cannot get through it. So we have to always keep that in mind. He is not going to allow us to be overburdened. As long as we're in His will, do things according to His will, and He will see that we get through. And we have to recognize that. We can't get lost in not recognizing who's going to get us through our times of trial and tribulation and burdens and so forth. Now, right after that part of the letter, the individual says, in complaining about the most undeserving people having everything, they are going to say, not a care in the world, and they're right. Not a care in this world. They go on living their life in this world as if they don't have a care, because in this world, they don't have a care. This is their world. This is the ungodly world for those who are going to remain ungodly. But remember, the Father tells us in the end, He is going to eliminate all this, all the unrighteousness, all the wicked. He's going to make His enemies His footstool. Now, we can choose to murmur and complain about not having what we see other undeserving individuals obtain in this world, but that is deception by the enemy. Don't let these things deceive you. Wicked and unjust people are obtaining everything all day. We see it in politics. We see it in business society. These people obtain all. They control everything. And we can't desire to want these things. These things are of wickedness anyway, for the most part. Now, what the Father allows us to have, what He blesses us with, we're blessed with. But remember, everything that He blesses us with comes responsibility. Now, if He gave us all that our hearts desired, we would probably be in the same boat as some of these undeserving, unrighteous people. We go left instead of continuing to go right in His way. So He understands. He knows us better than we do. Don't get caught up in thinking just because you see Mr. and Mrs. Wicked over here acquiring everything while you're struggling to survive, that something is wrong. The Father is not looking out for you. He doesn't care. Or at worst, He doesn't exist. No, we're going to go through what we go through. We have to constantly and continually be tested. Our faith and our loyalties to the Heavenly Father have to be strengthened. So when the times of trouble come in the end, we are prepared. We will have the strength through Him to go through, because things are going to get worse before they get better. So we have to keep this in mind. Now, the letter goes on to say, I just don't understand why God, a real God, would do this. I feel afraid and guilty about how I feel. I just don't know. Well, the truth of the matter is, you should feel guilty about that type of feeling, because that's the enemy laying the foundation for you to be totally deceived and led astray. He wants us to not believe the Father exists. He wants us to not trust in Him. Now, you also said in your letter that I've thought a time or two about what if I just end it. Who cares? I just don't understand what I am going through. People are more wicked than ever. It's just crazy. Please pray that I get it together. I hope I don't have to take other avenues. Now, and this is very true, don't get caught up in letting the enemy deceive you to a point to where you feel you need to start going to psychiatrists and doctors and all these other worldly, unnecessary for the most part, individuals. Because once you start that, then what do? They start prescribing drugs. Now, these things allow the enemy to work farther in individuals. When you start taking psychotropic drugs, then that opens up avenues for the enemy to do what? People hearing voices and all these things, because now there are more pathways for them to get in and cause chaos in our life. We have to hold on to what is real And what's true, the Father in times past was swift and quick in his justice. During the times of Noah, it grieved him that he had created man so badly that he wiped everything out. During the dispensation of Noah, of Abraham and all those patriarchs, justice was quick and swift. He would hit you with an ailment. He would wipe you off the face of this planet in an instant. But that dispensation is over. We're in a dispensation where people take the lack of immediate action by the Heavenly Father as a slackness. They take it as a reason that he doesn't exist. We take the notion that we can see undeserving individuals, according to our mind, we see undeserving individuals obtain so much, but we fail to realize that sometimes these blessings come from the enemy too. Remember, he is at work. He wants us to forget about him and blame or not blame the Heavenly Father. Ignore his existence and put everything on the Father. The enemy is just as busy. He's signing pacts with individuals every day, giving them every desire of their heart. But yet, some of us will sit back and go, what? Are you kidding me? They're just getting all this, that, and the other. God's not good to me, but look, he's blessing them with everything. The enemy blesses also. And with a lot of these same individuals, when the time is perfect, he pulls the carpet from under them. We see it with athletes, with politicians. They obtain so much. And then the next thing you know, you see them in the news making apologies for lying, cheating, stealing, what have you. The enemy seeks to destroy whom he may. Now, if he can get you, he can go in and get the rest of your family and everyone else. He is constantly at work. He knows us better than we know ourselves. Bottom line, the Heavenly Father is real. Don't lose that sight. Don't lose your hope. Don't lose your trust in him. Stay in the Word. The enemy wants us to forsake the Father. If we forsake him, he will forsake us. Don't ever doubt his existence. That's what the enemy wants us to do. Because as soon as we don't think he exists, we're done, because we're going to go on the side of the enemy, because we're caught up in the desires and things of this world, and we want of that. So stay focused, stay in the Word, and trust in him. And the more you go through, the more you should hang on to him, because he is the one who's going to get us through. And with that being said, we will pray for you, and pray for yourself and study. Stay in the Word. Don't lose your faith. This is 287. Remember, the Heavenly Father doesn't call on us to be successful. He calls us to be faithful. I'm out.